everyone. Mark Saltzman here at First Canadian Place in Toronto, celebrating the Team Canada send-off to the Intel International Science and Engineering Fair, or ISEF, in San Jose, California. 16 of Canada's brightest high school students will represent the country at the world's biggest science fair, where 1,500 kids from more than 50 countries will compete for up to $4 million in cash, prizes, and of course, scholarships. After addressing the crowd here to help wish Canada's top students luck in California, Doug Cooper, Intel's country manager, spoke with us about the significance of this event.
So we've got a few that are in the biosciences. They usually are very impressive sciences, typically kind of university grade science. Some people that are looking at new ways to improve chemotherapy treatments. We've got people looking at nanotechnology, new forms of energy. It covers a very broad range. And people think of Intel as the ingredient inside their computer. They often don't think about the fact that we're a company of scientists. Most of our population are physicists and mathematicians and chemists, and so we do science as a living.
Intel worked with Youth Science Canada, the organization that handpicked the final 16. We caught up with Rennie Barlow, Executive Director for Youth Science Canada.
Intel has so many connections and is such a well-respected company in Canada and around the world that connecting Youth Science Canada, Team Canada with Intel, and the fact that the kids are going off to the Intel International Science and Engineering Fair, it's a perfect fit. I think one of the things that these kids have realized and that these kids learn and will be happy to tell you is that science is serious fun. You know, it's serious in that it's a lot of work and that, you know, it really is tackling important problems and questions from today, but it's also a lot of fun.
And as you'll see with the three students that we've profiled, science fairs have come a long way since the bubbling volcano. Supreetha Neelam, a grade 12 student, talks about her ambitious study on the effect of antioxidants to reduce the environmental effects of fertilizer.
Well, essentially, there's a big problem nowadays with how excess fertilizer is being leaked out into the environment, and it's very detrimental to both humans and animals. And on a side note, there's antioxidants. We know antioxidants are beneficial to humans, but they're also very beneficial to plants.
And if you think science is boring, how about singing sisters Janelle and Vivienne Tam, age 14 and 17? The duo have developed a way to remove pharmaceutical contaminants in drinking water.
When you drink your drinking water straight from the tap, you don't know what drugs might be lurking in that.
Finally, a lot of buzz here surrounds Devish Arulmani's work on his bio-inspired photonic fuel cells. What does that mean exactly?
So essentially, the future of energy lies within hydrogen fuel cells, which are essentially a battery that combine hydrogen and oxygen to produce electricity.
You don't need an engineering degree to see that not only will these kids help shape our future, but they're doing it with smiles on their faces. At First Canadian Place in Toronto, I'm Mark Saltzman.